Eyestone here, coach of Jared Ward, top American in the New York City Marathon today. I mean, we were just talking. I didn't expect this the way he was talking about this before the race. Did you expect this?
I think I'm about as proud of him with this performance as I was at Rio. Just given the fact that, you know, sometimes your build-ups are not seamless to a marathon, and this certainly was an example of that. He had some really good training going on in the summertime and the early fall, and then he went to the Czech Republic to run a half marathon, just to kind of a tune-up, and his hamstring just tweaked on him, and it was difficult. We lost about 3 weeks, and we were this close to pulling the plug on it. And actually, David Monty sent him a really nice email and said, "Hey, guys aren't always 100% going into a marathon. Why don't we see it what goes?" And so we talked about it. Said, "Well, let's take it a week at a time." Yeah. And with each progressive week, then things just fell into place.
Yeah.
And so really, and then he got a little bit of a cold last week. So we were going, okay, it's not perfect, but let's see what happens, because he had this big reservoir of fitness.
Yeah.
And sometimes you just need to depend on your reservoir of fitness to get you through, and he's a very, very tough competitor. And that was a great race. I was inspired by that race today.
Yeah. So how was it, like, how were you following him? Because you were doing, like, the international.
Yeah, I was doing the international broadcast, but fortunately we had a top 10 feed, and you know, initially you're just riveted in covering whatever you're talking about for TV purposes. But I had my left eye on the top 10 once the break took place early on, because it was relatively conservative. At least through 5K or 10K, I could still see him in the back. I thought, okay, he's got a good one going on. And then after that, I just followed him on the top 10 board and saw him moving up from 10th to 9th. Kind of reminiscent of his Olympics, really. Just moving up, staying in there, being patient, picking people off as the race rolled out.
Did you guys have a pace or a game plan about how he was going to approach this
one? I think the game plan was, as we looked at the field, we certainly thought we could be the top American in, even without his perfect build-up. You know, we certainly were hoping for a top 10 position. But again, I think it surpassed expectations, given the fact that he was a little bit nicked up and everything. You know, the game plan was just to get out, run your own pace, and then pick people off at the end of the race, which is what he does, which is what his bread and butter is.
So, I mean, 4 years ago, he got sixth at Rio. Everyone was like, it's pretty firmly established he's the number two guy.
Yeah.
You know, behind Prof in the U.S.
Yeah.
And the injuries last year, didn't run a sprint marathon. Do you think he's back there now? I mean, does this show you
that he's still got a long ways to go, because this is with a bunch of hiccups going into a major race. But he's such a good, strong competitor. And to run, what did he run, 212, 22, or in that range? That's a great time on this course. You know, he's yet to really go on to be 100% on a flat, fast course. It's going to be fun to see him put that together. But, hey, you just do the best you can. And I think it's a great reminder to all of us that we're not always 100% going into events. You just make the best of what you do, and have confidence in your program, and have confidence in your buildup. And, you know, that's kind of what we were riding on, the fact that, yeah, he had about a 2.5-3 week chunk that the training was not good, and it was kind of day to day. Let's see if we can run today. And okay, let's wait till next week to try something hard. But you still have this reservoir of fitness to draw upon. And sometimes I think we go into marathons and we're a little overcooked, and maybe we need a little breather there, a couple week breather. That's not how we would have diagrammed the program. But sometimes I think a little bit of a rest there, you know, 6 weeks out, maybe it's not a bad thing, because it keeps you from being overcooked once you get to the event.
So what were the three? It was 3 weeks he missed. Like, what was the time? Where it wasn't really overcooked?
Yeah, it was at least 2 weeks. It was at least 2 weeks. But then we just kind of babied him back into things one thing at a time. And okay, let's try a 3 mile tempo run. Let's go on a long run, but maybe let's go on a 15 miler and then let's put 3 or 4 miles at marathon pace, see how that feels. Because we were this close. We were this close to pulling the plug because, you know, he had had a couple marathons where he hadn't done well and he didn't want to put himself in a position where it wasn't going to be at 100%. Yet it was far enough out 4 or 5 weeks ago when finally things were coming together. We kind of went, well, yeah, let's go for it. Let's see. It always gave us the opportunity, if it didn't go well, then to recycle and do something in the spring or, you know, or just wait. So he'll be able to make some nice choices off of this. I'm really proud of him. That's great.
All right, well, very nice job by your athletes.
Thank you. Yeah.